Other stuff later on. Looking forward to that, as I mentioned. We'll get to Ian Poulter a little bit later on today, too. Some baseball. You know, you're in a good time of the year here. I'll go through the hockey and the NBA standings for you, tell you where we stand last week of the regular season in the NHL. And obviously, you know, for the most part, 9 days to go in the NBA. So we'll get you going with that, give you some thoughts on the matchup scenarios as far as postseason is concerned and all that hoopla. Here is Rich in Massachusetts. He says hello first, and he's on Mad Dog Unleashed. Richard, good afternoon. Your turn. How are you today, pal? What do you have for me?
I'm good, Doug. You had a good holiday?
Yeah, I did, Rich. Thank you. Yourself?
I did, thank you. So, regarding the game tonight, as I told you before, I went to the East Regionals, and I've watched both teams play. And the first thing is, the Saturday night game was predictable for Kansas because Kansas shot lights out against Duke and still just barely won. And typically, things come back to the middle.
Right.
And so they didn't shoot well, and they have no other way to win. Now, Villanova, on the other hand, the same holds true for them, where they're not going to shoot lights out again, or at least unlikely, tonight. But against, as you said, against Texas Tech, they went like 4 for 17 or something like that.
Worse, 4 for 24. 4 for 24.
Okay. And they still, not only do they still win, but they out-rebounded. I believe if they didn't out-rebound, it was even. And Texas Tech's bigger than them. And so Villanova can still win without shooting lights out.
100%.
Now, Michigan, on the other hand, okay, they are playing great. Everybody said they were playing great going to the tournament, and they are. And but when you look at, like what you said, the road traveled, okay, in their own bracket, they started with Montana, okay, fine. Then they went to Houston, should have lost. Now, next round, do you want Texas A&M or North Carolina going into the game? You want Texas A&M. They got them, and they won. Then, the next round, do you want Xavier, Gonzaga, or Florida State?
You want Florida State.
You want Florida State.
Yep.
Right. Now you go to the next round. Do you want Arizona, Virginia, Kentucky, or Loyola? So, there were so many teams that were better, or at least on paper and in theory, than the teams they ended up playing. It's not their fault. You got to play who's in front of you. But that being said, this is far and away, as it would anyway, because they're the best team, you know, a big step up for them.
Now, nope.
And they're going to need the Duncan Robinson and the other kid. And I saw Duncan play at Williams, and he was good then. I didn't know he'd be good enough to, you know, to do what he's doing now. But he's going to have to, you know, hit a bunch of threes along with a couple of the other guys, because you're right about Wagner. He's really good, but I think they'll neutralize him. Because let me tell you talked about all those players. That kid Spellman, he's a freshman. That kid's a beast.
Yeah, he's a hell of a player. Hell of a player, and he will do a good job on Wagner. And see, Villanova, folks, if they don't shoot well, they can still win. Because they rebound the ball, as Rich just said. They rebound the ball. They play good defense. They have other ways they can beat you. They got a veteran point guard who can get somebody a shot, get in a lane. They have other ways. I'm not sure if Michigan does. If Michigan doesn't shoot the ball well on this level of team. Now, against a lousy team, Michigan can shoot 2 for 18 against Florida State and survive. I don't know if they can do that from 3 in this kind of game. So, there's just not as many paths for Michigan in this game as there are for Villanova. Villanova's got 5, they got 7 good players. 6.5. I mean, they got the freshman kid who comes in, he's okay. They got the other kid from downtown Philly, he's okay, pretty good, you know, he's a good athlete. DiVincenzo, whatever his name is very good, he's a great athlete, he can shoot. And then they got the starting 5 of Booth and Brunson and Bridges and Pasquale and Spellman. I mean, that's a very, very, very good team. It's a good college team, this Villanova team. And the coach is good. So, I mean, this is a tricky spot. Now, the one thing I'd be a little worried about, again, as I've said already, is that, you know, they really haven't, you know, they didn't play great against Texas Tech. But, you know, some of these times in these one game, you're not going to win every game. And, you know, Villanova's been great now in two tournaments in the last 3 years. Last year, they had their hiccup against Wisconsin. But they've been great against, they were great against that whole run against Kansas, North Carolina 2 years ago. And then, of course, what they've done this year. Eventually, you might lose a game. Now, that would work. That's the one thing that would concern me. And, you know, Beilein's back in a championship game again. You know, you give him enough chances to win a title, one of these years he's going to win one. But I, on paper, with the matchup that I see in front of me, I don't see any way that the Michigan wins this game. Now, you got to play it, but I don't see a way they can win. Eric in Long Island, New York, and he says hello, and he's our Mad Dog Unleashed. Hello, Eric. How are you today, pal?
I'm doing good, dog. Hey, quick side note before we get to the Final Four then tonight. Looking forward to that show next week at the NHL store. You always do a good job with it. Make sure you save some time for phone calls because I know you got a lot of guests.
That's going to be a week from Wednesday. We'll do 4 hours that day. Eric, a huge hockey fan. New York not involved in the NHL postseason this year, except for the Devils. No Rangers, no Islanders. So we'll see what sort of reaction that gets in the in the tri-state. But Eric will be involved. I'm sure Sean in Queens will hear from him, and away we go. Go ahead. Next.
Dog, and I'll tell you right now, we're about 2 weeks away from the NFL schedule release. I'm telling you right now, I want Howard Katz at 3 o'clock the following day for an hour breaking down that schedule. You know that's going to be big ratings here in New York because people will be into that. So I'm looking forward to that schedule.
I love the schedule. Katz will definitely come on. We'll make sure of it. I promise. Go ahead. Next.
All right, dog. As far as the Final Four goes Saturday, listen, first half of Loyola, Michigan, very, very hard watch, dog. A lot of missed shots, you know, low 20s. I mean,
yeah, bad game. Bad game.
You know, and then once Michigan made the run down 10 and got it tied, I mean, did you not think for 1 second that they would blow right past Loyola? You know, even though, when they got that game tied with about 5 minutes to go, you know, I said to myself, there's no way this game's coming down to the final possession. They're just going to steamroll them from here. And they went on that, you know, what is it, 32-12 run to end the game. I mean, that game wasn't in doubt in the last minute or so. Terrible game. And as far as Villanova Kansas goes, I mean, I don't even think Kansas played well, bad in the first half. It's just when Villanova hits 13 three-pointers, 11 in the first half. I mean, how is Kansas supposed to stay in the game? They shot the lights out. I mean, that was just, you know, by 10 minutes ago in the second half, you're trying to find things to watch at 10 o'clock on a Saturday night. And I'll say this about tonight. You know, I give Michigan a shot only because of Beilein. I think he can come up with a couple of things to keep his team in the game. But, you know, if Michigan doesn't pull a Texas A&M performance where they're shooting a lot of three-pointers and making them, I don't see how they win this game. If the game is in the 50s, I favor Villanova. And I think if the game's in the 80s, Villanova can outscore them. So I have a hard time believing that, you know, outside of Beilein, you know, being a tremendous coach coming up in a way, I have a hard time thinking Michigan will win tonight's game. You know that?
100%. I mean, that was my basic point at the top. I don't see it. I don't see how, in fact, now listen, you got to play the game. It's only one game. It's 40 minutes. I mean, we've seen crazy upsets. I never thought UCLA with the backup point guard was going to beat Arkansas that year, and they killed him with Cameron Love. What the heck is his name? Cameron Dollar when Baron Davis got hurt. So, I mean, I've watched enough of these games that you never know with the one game. The better team doesn't always win the one game deal. But Villanova has been very, you know what they remind me a little of? They remind me a little bit of that Florida team that won the back-to-back championships. You know, they remind me a little bit of that. They're very, very reliable, Villanova. They have, you know, they got a lot of guys who are seasoned. They've been there before. That was that Florida team of, you know, Noah and Horford. You know, not great players, but good players. A couple of good NBA players. Brewer was on that team. This team reminds me a little bit of that. I've been thinking about that all weekend. Ronnie in Michigan, and he's got a chance. He wants to give his Wolverines a chance. Ron, welcome. How are you today? Yes, Ron, you're on Mad Dog Unleashed. How are you? Okay? Things good? All right, Ron is not there, so we say hello to John in Ohio, and he joins us here on Mad Dog Unleashed. Johnny, good afternoon. How are you today? Johnny, you there? All right. Eddie is busy doing something else, and that's what happens. We lose these calls. We'll try one more, and then we'll go to Gabe Kapler. Here's Mike in South Carolina. Michael, good afternoon. How are you today?
I'm good, Chris. Just trying to avoid all this Augusta traffic. You know, the Masters is down here. I'm 35 minutes away. So
you live 35 minutes over the border in South Carolina.
Yeah, yes, sir. Chris,
and a lot of people are getting into the. Getting into Augusta today and tomorrow. Basically, what you're telling me.
Yes, it's going to be packed. All they're talking about is Tiger down here. That's all you hear.
Well, we're going to do a lot of Tiger in 90 minutes.
Good for the economy. You know, Chris, my whole thing is because we had two worst games. Saturday night. Those were snooze fest.
Terrible.
I mean, terrible. And my whole thing is that and I stood by what I told you last Monday. My Blue Devils wouldn't have beat Villanova either.
I agree.
That was a great point by your previous caller. I mean, when it was 22-4, I was just shaking my head the way they were shooting. Was something special. But, Chris, I know time's short. Let me leave you this. I don't know if Villanova's going to cover. But I don't see how they lose. But every team has a puncher chance. We saw State beat Houston. But my thing is, if they do win it, and they win 2 out of 3, they're the gold standard now, Chris. And this coach isn't a good coach, Chris. He's a great coach. Villanova's coach is a great coach. You win 2 out of 3, you go up the pecking ladder a lot, don't you think, Chris?
Yeah, absolutely.
Great coach.
Absolutely.
And I think they're going to get it done. I don't necessarily know if they're going to cover because they might not shoot lights out. I don't know how they're going to shoot that way in 2 games in a row, but they're going to win. And that's 2 out of 3, and that's something special right there, Chris, in this day and time.
Yeah, and remember, he's also been in another Final Four, too. So, I mean, he's had 3 runs at this. He had the Final Four against Carolina. He got to a regional final loss to Florida, and he's got a chance to win 2 championships. I mean, and this is a guy who, 12 years ago was laboring away at Hofstra. So, I mean, think about it for a second with Jay Wright. He's found himself in a good way. And, again, I think the key here, Mike, for them is they don't get the one-and-done player, but they get the borderline NBA player. So
great point. Great college teams. When you can have guys stay 3 or 4 years, as my Blue Devils are finding out, Chris, you need those guys. You got to have them. The one and dones, it's hard to get it done with the one and dones. That's why it doesn't happen every year. And in fact, it's getting to be rare that it does happen. Is Kentucky and Duke winning every year?
Well, the thing about the one and dones, you won't have an off year. If you have the one and done, you're going to be in the NCAA tournament. I mean, that's you're going to be there in the NCAA because you got too much talent, but you may not win the whole thing, is what you're basically telling me. And as far as these two teams are concerned right now, Villanova and Michigan, Michigan's gone this way too. They get a lot of these good players who are, pretty good NBA players. They make an NBA roster, which is hard to do. Maybe one of them will be a factor, maybe two, Brunson in his case, Bridges, but they stay more than a year or two. And so they have experience. They're playing 2 years ahead of freshmen. And it gives them a huge advantage. Jeremy Huber, a Sports Bite here on Mad Dog Unleashed.